Hi there, my name is Kaylee. This is a physics lesson on friction and the energy due to friction. In the real world, we know that a skateboarder can't roll forever. Yes, she will get tired, but there's also something that naturally slows her down. But what is that thing? It's called friction, and friction is a force that stops things from moving. Think about pushing a toy car on a thick carpet, or trying to ride your bike on the sand. These surfaces have a lot of friction and make it hard to move. There are some surfaces that have more friction and some that have less. So we already talked about the two surfaces that have a lot of friction, so things like thick carpet and sand. But what are types of surfaces that would have less friction or make it easier to move on? How about shiny wood floors? Think about how easy you can slide across them in your socks. Or a frozen lake or ice skating rink. You can glide right across. And that means that there's little or no friction on those surfaces. But friction can also show up as energy. And remember, energy can never be created or destroyed. But there's something else that's special about friction when it shows up as energy. Let's do an experiment. I want you to take your hands and you're going to bring your palms together like you're going to clap. And now you're going to take them and you're going to rub your hands really fast back and forth. Really fast. Keep it going. Do you hear my hands? For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Did you notice anything? If your palms got hot from moving them back and forth, that's friction energy. It shows up as heat, and it's also called thermal energy to remind you that it shows up as heat. And just like kinetic energy and potential energy, thermal energy has a checklist so that we know if it exists. The checklist is two surfaces, like our two hands or car tires in the road, and we need speed or movement between those two surfaces, like how we rubbed our hands together or how a car's tire will roll down the road. But how do we transfer kinetic energy to thermal energy? Think about when we rubbed our hands together and we used friction to make heat. You used kinetic energy by moving your hands. And that kinetic energy was turned into thermal energy or heat that you felt. Let's look at another example. Say you're going to push a toy car. Just one push and you're going to lift your hand away so that the car will roll on its own. What will happen? It'll roll for a while and then it's going to stop. And that's because you gave the car kinetic energy when you pushed it. And the car has mass and speed, but the car also had two surfaces, the tire and the floor that were rubbing against each other, and the car moved from when you pushed it. And even though you probably didn't feel it or notice it, a tiny amount of heat came from the friction of the tires and the floor rubbing together. And that's what happens when there's thermal energy. Heat shows up and it slows it down. So let's take these ideas of friction and thermal energy back to our skateboarder. And we can see what happens when there's potential energy, kinetic energy, and thermal energy all in one. All right, so we're back to our skateboarder. Remembering our ramp here and our skateboarder here, and most of our tools here are the same. We have our mass slide bar. We can make her smaller or bigger, so heavier, lighter. Leave it here in the middle. We have our speedometers. We can know how fast she's going. And then we have our bar graph here. So now we are going to be worried about thermal energy because now we know what thermal energy is. So we're going to look and see how kinetic energy and potential energy change when there's friction involved. And we can make the ramp either no friction, like the first video, a little bit of friction, or a lot. All right, so let's get started. It's going to start out a lot like the first video when we had no friction present. So if we take our skateboarder, we're going to put her up on the ramp here. You'll see she has no speed. She's at rest. She has no kinetic energy. She has no thermal energy because you have to be moving to have friction present. So all of her energy is in potential energy because she is high off of the ground. All right. So we've put our friction slide right here about in the middle. So let's see what changes as friction on the ramp shows up as thermal energy. So there's going to be heat from her tires, the wheels here, rubbing on the ramp. And that'll be thermal energy. And we'll see if it slows her down and ends up stopping her. So let's see what happens. So there she goes. She has speed. She has kinetic energy. But look at this. There's also thermal energy that's kicking in here, that red bar. And as that red bar gets bigger, both of these are getting smaller. So let's try it one more time. And let's do it in slow motion this time. We're going to take her. We're going to put her up at the top again. Let's see. We're going to do it in slow motion. So only potential energy. What happens? She's going. So the minute she starts to go, we see a tiny bit of that red bar. Kinetic energy. Let's see. It's going. It's slowing down a little bit. That thermal energy is getting bigger. Kinetic energy is getting smaller. So now thermal energy is beating both of them. It's higher. There it is. All right, so let's try it one more time. Let's watch her speed bar here. So we're going to put her back up here. Same thing, potential energy to start. Now, instead of paying attention only to the bar graph here, let's look at the speed and see what happens to the speedometer. So she's going. She's getting kinetic energy. She's making all the way up to halfway up the speedometer. What happens the next time she goes? She's only about here. Let's see, can she make it there again? Nope, only about here. What's going to happen to the next time? Only to here. So see how she's getting slower. Her speed is not picking up to the same level that it was. So remember, that's kinetic energy is being transferred to that thermal energy. And then she can't ever come back to that potential energy because she's not getting that high on the ramp because she doesn't have the speed to get back up there. So now let's see, we're going to let her come all the way to a stop. She's almost there. And look at what's happening. Thermal energy is now the total energy. There's just barely any left. She's almost down. Look at, she's almost going only to zero. And look at that. Thermal energy is right there at the top. So friction, thermal energy actually slowed her all the way down to a stop. And all of that energy, all of that kinetic and potential energy that she had has been dissipated, has shown up as heat in the system. So let's go one more time. This time let's make her friction be a lot and see if it changes what happens. So we're letting her go. Same thing, kinetic energy as she goes down, potential energy comes back. But look at this time, thermal energy is growing even faster. So the ramp is even harder to move on. So instead of getting about 6 or 8 passes, she's only getting about 4. And then she has to stop. There's so much friction that she's stopping even sooner. And let's see what happens this time if we make it really low friction. So now she's barely any friction. And she's starting out. Only potential energy up there. Let's see. Kinetic energy is going pretty high. Just a little bit. Each pass as she goes, she gets speed. The thermal energy comes up. Wow. So it's going a lot slower. So she's going to be able to do more passes on the ramp because there's less friction. So it's easier to move this time. She's able to get almost as high on the ramp as the time before. So her potential energy is coming back up. It's just getting a little bit lower as this thermal energy bar raises. And as the friction turns to heat, because she's moving, so that kinetic energy is turning into thermal energy. Nice. So good. So now as these ideas are starting to make more sense, the next thing we're going to do is talk about the mathematical equations that go along with energy. So they each have their own equation here, kinetic, potential, and thermal. So make sure you watch those videos next, the equations for the different energies. And remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.